going to New Orleans. Mikey stepping back once more. Still on the west side. We just went through the purple. Now we go into the gold and white. New Orleans, Pelicans, Zion, Ohion Williamson. Trying to lead the effort in taking this team to the next level. They were so close last year to make the playoffs. And now they've lost some, but they may have gained some. We'll talk about their transactions and their additions and where they may land. Long list. I'm going to go over who's key. Justin Wright Foreman, free agent. I like his talent. Ryle Hawkins, a guy who I like as well, free agent. Tony Carr, free agent. Brandon Ingram was also a free agent. Derek Favors, we'll talk about him. We'll see if he's still there. Etwan Moore is another guy. Frank Jackson, Jahlil Okafor, Kendrick Williams. I see Joshua Gray there. And then Zylan Cheatham. That's a long list of guys becoming free agents. The guys in December that are free agents are more than likely cut off the team. So Tony Carr, Ryle Hawkins, Justin Wright Foreman, and Jared Utoff plus Eke Anadubu are probably gone. So let's go into the signings and who did they sign. This was just a practice squad. We know about the new addition in the draft, Kyrie Lewis Jr. Exciting pick for them. Not sure what this means for Lonzo Ball. You do need two guards in this league, so I appreciate that. But again, that is a big pick and a potential game changer for the Pelicans, who are now officially a full-on running team when you add this kid onto the squad, one of the fastest guys in the draft. Sedarius Thornwall comes over, good experience with the Clippers. Wayne Gabriel was on the Sacramento Kings and moved around to Portland. Not a bad player as well. Brandon Ingram, got to re-sign him. And then Willie Hernan Gomez is another guy. So the exercise is team options on Jackson Hayes, a key contributor for them defensively. Nick L, Alexander Walker, their scores, re-signing, and then Zion Williamson. These were the three rookies that were drafted. Options exercise. Now we get into the acquisitions. Big trade, Drew Holiday is no longer with the team, right? That's what I wanted to show, but it wasn't showing it here. He was traded. They get Eric Bledsoe. They also get in Steven Adams from the OKC Thunder. So not a bad move there. Okay, these are the guys that I talked about, the guys they waived. So you add on Bledsoe, you add on Adams, but you've lost Derek Favors. You've lost Jahlil Okafor. You've lost Frank Jackson. I mean, that's, you lost a lot of guys. So how does their lineup look now? Where's their depth chart? And are they still in the same position without Jahlil Okafor, without Derek Favors, and without, of course, Frank Jackson? When we look at their roster, I'm just going to their depth chart and who they're trying to play. Lonzo Ball's there. Obviously, Kyrie Lewis is going to come into the second slot from a guard position. They're solid, very solid at the guard position. I expect more big things from Lonzo. The progression, the growth, continue to grow, young man. Again, they talk about his brother LaMelo so much, but no offense, LaMelo is Lonzo with a better shot. At the end of the day, that's what he is to me, and I think Lonzo has improved his shot so much, I would argue that Lonzo may be on top of LaMelo as far as shooting. Eric Bledsoe is another guy, all right? He comes in, they got this double guard thing they may be doing. I don't like that lineup. Think they're too small, but Lonzo, remember, 6'5", 6'6", so they think they can interchange him. I'd rather feed Bledsoe into the second slot, but he's highly paid, or excuse me, he's a bigger name, so you know it's possibly a forced hand. I loved Redick at that shooting guard position, but he's older, and that's a consequence, so now he looks like he's coming off the bench. Who's the guy that can totally step up and make things a little bit different is Nickeil Alexander Walker. It'd be good to see him continue to grow and get opportunities at the guard position. I think he's a potential sixth man of the year. Josh Hart is the consummate glue guy, can play either the forward or guard position. Love his style, love his heart, love his play. He's going to be a guy as well as a big key contributor to this team. So we shall see what happens. Guard position, they're a little light at shooting guard, in my opinion. No true shooting guard at this position. They're running in guards. And everyone's doing it now in the league. So it is what it is. It may even out because everybody's doing it. However, don't like seeing Eric Bledsoe at your shooting guard position. Okay? Next up, small forward Brandon Ingram gets in there. They re-sign him, gave him a big contract. Josh Hart's his backup. Little light here. Little light at the backup small forward position. Hart is there at times. He is 6'6". As a full-time small forward, as a backup to Brandon Ingram, want a little bit more height. They did add Wayne Gabriel. Najee Marshall's there and Sedarius Thornwell. Not sure if they have enough height or skill at this position. They're a little light for New Orleans. Interesting to see the moves they made, again, and trying to solidify their team, but did not address this backup forward position. Now, we continue on for two kind of light positions. You jump into the big power forward position. You got big Zion. He's a whole hell of a lot. Should have a breakout year this season. He'll be green-lighted, but then you got Nicolo Melli from the outside. So you got two sides of the coin, two ways that you can get killed. And I think Zion is in good hands here. However, even here, I still do not like the third squad in the bench, right? You got Ingram coming in, a power forward. Wayne Gabriel's there. He's a nice glue guy. I like his potential to, you know, rebound in slots and things like that. But full-time, I don't know. So he's going to see minutes. Nicolo Melli's not going to be going full-time at that role. Now, the one position I think they're solid, and it was an okay move with Derek Favors, is Jackson Hayes with Steven Adams. Steven Adams, one of the better setters in the NBA, joins Mr. Jackson Hayes, another budding star. They're both going to have similar type of careers, in my opinion. Hayes appears to be the more athletic at this time. Adams definitely the stronger. I like this side of them on the Pelicans. I think they're solid here. I think they have their center position wrapped up, and to add on to it, you got another army guy or crazy head is Willie Hernan Gomez. The only issue that I see here is that he got no stretch guy. There's no stretch five. And you're saying, it's NBA. Center's just supposed to back up, and that's no longer the NBA. Now your center has to shoot. So now it's interesting that they just have Steven Adams there with Jackson Hayes. Willie Hernan Gomez, I believe, has a little bit of a shot. That's who they're going to have to rely on to stretch the floor. With these two in there, the lanes will be clogged because they know these two can't shoot. So that's an interesting position for them, similar to the Lakers with Dwight Howard and McGee last year. Clog the lane with these two bigs in there because you know they can't shoot. So that's interesting. Melly's the stretch guy. Josh Hart's the other three-point shooter. Alexander Walker's the other three-point shooter. Now I'm worried about consistency and their percentages and effort to be able to truly keep up with this NBA and all of the strengths from all the teams. When I go into the division, let's just jump there and look at it and be real with ourselves, right? We looked at the roster and we said, yeah, all these guys have come in, and potentially they should be making another playoff run. But when you lose Jahlil Okafor, Derek Favors, and Frank Jackson Jr., who was kind of filling in that shooting guard slot, I think there's more damage to be done from a where-you-head perspective next year. With the West lined up the way it is, let's look at the sides and different divisions and where could they possibly fit in. I'll start with the Southwest where they're at. Is this team better than the Rockets? That's a question mark. Okay, without Harden, it's a big question mark. I know Wall and Cousins will give it a balls ringer. It's going to be tough to beat those two, but they're probably even out, right? Big two. Lonzo, Williamson, and Ingram. A Wall, Gordon, and Cousins. They're probably evened out. That's a tough one, all right? Memphis Grizzlies, they rely on more all-around ball, but they're more cohesive unit, so they're more dangerous. Remember the Detroit Pistons back in the day, okay, even though they had some all-stars there. Just trying to give an example, you don't need a superstar. Memphis Grizzlies are in the same ilk. They're playing together. They like each other. That's another big thing. So that's another advantage served. Are they better than New Orleans? I would say that's another even question mark. Dallas, with the moves they made, a healthy Porzingis, a healthy Luka Doncic, what does that mean for that squad, right? Are they finally catapulting themselves into maybe a sixth or fifth slot in the playoffs? Can they knock off Houston? Can they knock off Phoenix or Golden State, who are trying to make their comeback? That's the interesting play here. Dallas, I think, has the talent and the experience to be able to make a good run. Again, are the New Orleans Pelicans better than that team? Question mark for me again. I don't know. San Antonio Spurs, the consummate coach team that now has additional athletic talent. I think from an athletic perspective, probably the best they've been. Does this team make a run? The way I see it, New Orleans has a tough run, and they're chasing the A spot. They're in their hunt. I'm not going to throw them out because of what we may see
and Zion, Ingram, and Ball. Let's see the improvement of Ball. But then you get over to the Pacific side, okay? And that's where it gets even more dangerous. Clippers, Lakers, forget about it. No. Phoenix Suns, maybe they can catch those guys, right? Sacramento Kings are not in conversation for me. And I may be wrong there, barring no injuries in the NBA, but I just don't see who's there. Golden State Warriors, very, very interesting team, right? Even losing their main man, Klay Thompson, can they still make a run? That's the question mark. We shall see. Denver Nuggets, you know, getting negged up. I said they're going to have a tough year making the playoffs because of all they lost. It'll be interesting to see how they end up. It's all about who steps up. Will Bo or Mike Porter Jr. make the moves? Not sure, but that's really their state of mind and state of situation. Those guys will have to step up for them to make a good run. Minnesota Timberwolves, a team with expectations that made a lot of big moves, got the top draft pick. I would think they should have been catapulted into the playoff race from the preseason looks. It doesn't look too good. However, from a talent perspective, they have all the little pieces that they need to make that push. Current state, I think your guys, New Orleans, are better than this team because they haven't gelled, but they could be a sleeper if they can put it together, get the right coaching. Oklahoma City's headed for the draft. Portland Trailblazers. So now we're up to about 9 or 10 teams already. And then you add on the Utah Jazz. You know, we're at 11 teams that could potentially make the playoffs. And now you got New Orleans that lost some of their guys and are thinking they're going to be in the same slot. It'll be interesting to see next year if they make it. They'll be on the hunt. But right now, I got them out of that window right now. They need another talent. I mentioned the small four role. There's not enough depth there for backup at small forward, and the guard position to me is still a little bit light. If anything, even though it would hurt Zion Williamson and Lonzo Ball, since James Harden wants to leave so bad, this team may have enough assets if they keep Williamson, Ingram, and Ball, and you're able to trade the rest of some of these guys, get them over to the Houston Rockets. That may be an opportunity for James to step in because they need that guard help. However, not sure if he will go to this team and not sure how that would work for his Ball handling the ball because he likes to control the pace. So I'm going to sign off here with my status on, New Orleans Pelicans. Get it, Mardi Gras. I don't think you're going to make it in, man. I'm sorry. Mikey, stepping back again. I'm out. Peace.